Hello again. In the last video, we learned about how to declare and use an int, a variable of type int. So int is one of the data types we now know in addition to Boolean. We learned a number of operations we can perform where we use two integers to get a new integer. And we also learned that we can use two integers and relational operations to actually get a Boolean value, right? N greater than 0 is that's an expression that's going to evaluate to true or false, and therefore we can use it as our while loop condition. We also learned that integers have a maximum and a minimum possible value they can store. And I actually don't think we learned the answer to what this little bit of code here does that keeps counting up as long as n is greater than 0. It turns out when you reach about 2 billion-ish, actually 2 to the 31st minus 1 in particular, you've reached the maximum integer value. And when you add 1 to that value, you actually get the minimum integer value, which is around negative 2 billion. It happens to be negative 2 to the 31st. And negative 2 to the 31st is not greater than 0, so we would actually exit the loop upon reaching the highest integer value. So it's important, I think, to know that there's some sort of wraparound, where when you go too high, you actually start getting a number that's too low when you work with integers. And the solution is, if you work with the int data type, stay away from numbers that are as high as 2 billion. Otherwise, you can expect some weird behavior. And I think in another video, we'll take a look at exactly why that occurs. But I want to focus on how to actually solve problems using integers. So let's bring up our favorite little robot. And the challenge is, I want to program the robot to go to the wall at the end of the hallway and back and end up exactly where it started. And not only that, it should work no matter where the robot starts. So if I start the robot here, it should walk to the wall and then back to that exact spot. So that's the challenge. I'm not claiming this is a useful method, but I think it will be excellent practice and it will help us work up to some useful methods. So here we go. Public static. Now going to the wall and back, that doesn't require an answer. So that would return void since we don't get back a return value. And let's see. Let's call it go to wall and back. Never hurts to be explicit about what our method is going to do. And we'll indicate that the robot ends in same position direction as it starts. So that's our post condition, our after condition. But of course, in the meantime, it visits the wall. So how do we do that? Well, the first step is going to the wall. And that's actually not so bad. Going to the wall that involves repeatedly moving. That would be, by the way, if you hear some meowing, that's my cat getting hungry again. Repeatedly moving, that means I need a loop. I only know one kind of loop at the moment, that's a while loop. And I write it as a sort of fill in the blank, like Mad Libs or something. And I can write this in any order, but I know that the thing I do repeatedly is robot.move, the move method being declared in the robot file, so we say robot.move, and I do that repeatedly, and I stop when the front is no longer clear. That means I keep looping when the front is clear. And front is clear is also declared in the robot file, so I've written it like this. Well, front is clear, move, and now we've got to the end. So that brings us to the second part of the task, which is go back to where you started. Uh-oh. How do I know where I started? How do I know where I started? I have no idea how many times to back up. I'll tell you, I actually do have a method called backup. It's defined up here somewhere. There it is, backup, turn around, move, and turn around. So there is a backup method. But I don't know how many times to back up. And so the observation is the number of times I should back up is equal to the number of times I moved. So What I need to do when I move is remember how many times I've moved. And the fact that I need to remember something tells me I should use a variable. That's the only way in Java I can remember something. So I'm going to create a variable. And that variable is going to remember how many times I moved. So I can call it whatever I want. I'm declaring it. Well, maybe that's not obvious. Let's try declaring it in here first. So we'll do it in the wrong way, and then we'll fix it. So I'm declaring a value that's going to remember, a variable that will remember a number, so it will be of type int. And it's going to be the number of times I moved. So I might call it, or number of steps I've taken maybe, so we could call it num steps. In fact, maybe we could be more specific. It's not just the number of steps, it's not the number of steps until the end, it's the number of steps I've already taken. So we could call that something like num steps taken. Or we could even, I like this name the best, we could say something like num steps from start. The number of steps I've taken from the start. Okay, now, num steps from start, what should happen to that number? Well, every time I move, it should increase. So every time I move, it should increase. How do I increase the value stored in a variable? Well, I do two things. I retrieve that value from the variable. I take the value I retrieved and I add one to it. And then I take that sum and I store it using an assignment statement. I store it somewhere in memory. And the best place to store it is exactly where that value was before. So we're going to see this trick over and over again. In order to increment the value in a variable, an integer variable, we say variable equals variable plus 1. So num steps from start equals num steps from start plus 1. Add 1 and store that sum as the new number of steps from the start. We'll do that every time we move, so these two lines should get executed around the same time, one after the other. And actually, let's hit compile, because I think that will help us see an error. So I've hit compile, I hit F5, and now it tells me one error. And the error is variable num steps from start might not have been initialized. So Java's upset that I'm using the value, I'm retrieving the value of this variable before I've ever stored a value in it, right? Initialized means store the first value inside that variable. And we've never stored any value inside this variable, so we can't retrieve it and add one. What value should we store in this variable at the very beginning? Well, how many steps from the start is the robot at the beginning of the program? It's 0, because it hasn't taken any steps yet. So we should start with a value, and I'm still doing this incorrectly, but it's a step in the right direction. I should start with a value of 0. Start with a value of 0, and then we can increment it. Now, something is going to go terribly wrong with this code. This loop right now says, declare that I will store an integer, initialize it to 0, take a step, take 0 plus 1, which is 1, and store it back in that variable, and then we reach the closing brace. And remember, when we reach the closing brace where a variable was declared, that variable dies, it gets forgotten. So we say 0 plus 1 is 1, and then we forget it. Well, that's not a good thing. We don't want to forget it. We want to remember that value. So that tells me I should declare it outside the loop. All right, so now we declare it outside, and while the front is clear, we initialize to 0, we take a step forward, we say 0 plus 1 is 1, and we store that away. And we remember it for the next time through the loop, because we haven't the variable didn't die, because it exists out here, so it actually dies with this closing brace for the method. But something else goes wrong, because now, after the robot has taken a step, and we increment this number, and we come back, and we test that the front is still clear, and we enter the loop, num steps from start goes back to 0. So the observation is, we do want to move over and over again, and we do want to increment the number of steps from the start over and over again, so those things should be inside our loop. But we only want to start at 0 once. So that does not belong in our loop. That line should occur before the loop, and I think that's a common error that we'll make for a while when we're working with loops, but maybe I can convince you not to make that error. So declare the variable and initialize it before the loop, and then whenever we're using a variable as a sort of counter, like we are here, and then each time through the loop, we'll move and we'll increment. And when we get to the end of the loop, that number will be the number of steps. And Well, let's see. That brings us to, I know the number of steps. I'm just printing out the answer so that we can see if it even works. In fact, we could print it as it moves. Maybe that would be more interesting. Each time you take a step and increment, print out how many steps we've taken. So let's see how that does. So I just compiled, and oh, I have to go way back for this. Load my haul.txt file, and method was called goToAll and back, even though it doesn't go back yet. And I think it's in a file called lesson. Yep, lesson. Lesson.goToAll and back. Let's see what happens. Robot moves, and every time the robot moves, it's kind of a dark color, I don't know if you could see it, but it's counted. So apparently it took 9 steps. We saw it counting up from the first step, which was 1, all the way to the 9th step, which is 9, so apparently there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times that we move, 9 steps that the robot takes. So then the next question is, now that we've worked so hard to count, so that when we get to the end, we know we've taken 9 steps, how do we take 9 steps back until we get back to the beginning? And I'll leave you with that mystery until the next video.